y'all. I'm about to do some legs. It's like 5 in the morning. I'm about to hit some legs. And then, you know what I mean? I'm gonna go get to the money. So, we'll be right back. Side of the haters. People love me when I go crazy in the gym, when I'm getting it in and I'm grinding. You also got them positive people that tell you, like, you know, they'll compliment you and know that's your hard work, notoriety. So we got to get on these leg extensions now. Let's get it.
Booster G.
Gifts.
He named his sermon,
but especially that you may prophesy, proclaim the truth among all.
Listen to this.
Reveal the word of God. For he who speaks in a tongue does not speak to men, but who? To God. For no one understands him. However, in the spirit, he speaks mysteries. And that's a good thing, but there's a place for it. But he who prophesies speaks edification, exhortation, and comfort to men. That is both believers and non-believers, church. Verse 4, he who speaks in a tongue edifies himself, and that's not a bad thing, but he who prophesies edifies the church. I wish you almost spoke the tongues, says the Apostle Paul, but even more that you prophesied. For he who prophesies, that is, proclaims the word of God, is greater, that is, more beneficial than he who speaks with tongues, unless indeed he interprets, that the church may receive edification. As I mentioned last time, so I say it again, this is an awesome chapter that we must beware of the temptation to be just simply theologically correct as we interpret the scriptures in light of scriptures. We must look at this chapter with the determination to put it into practice. Why? Two main reasons. Number one, this chapter reveals the ownership of Jesus Christ regarding his people and his church, and he magnifies that by the power of the Holy Spirit. Number two, the empowerment is present in the church if we obey what God's word has to say, and the Holy Spirit will use you and I to build one another up. Ladies and gentlemen, church family, I don't know how you feel this morning, your first service, and it's early and it's cool outside and all that kind of stuff. You may or may not have had breakfast or a cup of coffee, I don't know. Put all that aside. The truth of the matter is, you and I right now, if we're Christians, we have been designed to minister to one another, and to edify one another in the Lord. And when we walk with Jesus, that's what's going to happen. When we don't walk with Jesus, we're going to tear down.
Yeah, that's what
Hey, I got y'all replied to go to your stuff or something.